Assalamu alaikum. Today I am going to start chapter 4, English class 9. As you know, we have already completed chapter 1, 2 and 3. That is Bhola Grandpa, All About Dog and the poem Autumn. So today we will start chapter 4, A Day in a Zoo. The name of the author, Gerald Malcolm Durrell. He was an English zookeeper. He founded that is now called the Durrell Wildlife Conservation Trust and the Jersey Zoo. Jersey is in Europe. So the following passage is an extract of his chapter where the author talks about how he set up his own zoo in Jersey, that is in Europe, helped by a team dedicated to the cause of animal. The extract describes a typical day in a zoo and the experience of the zoo workers and offers an interesting insider view of the zoo. It means that sometimes we go to visit zoo, but with the help of this chapter, we will be able to know the problems inside the zoo, the experience inside the zoo. That means as a zookeeper, we will get an experience of a zookeeper and activities of different animals. So let us start this chapter. It is one thing to visit a zoo as an ordinary member of the public. It is quite another thing to own a zoo and live in it. That means the author used to live inside the zoo. It certainly enables you to rush out at any hour of the day or night to observe the animals. It means if you are living inside the zoo, you will have to observe the animals at any time, whether it is night or day. It also means you are on duty 24 hours a day. The average zoo day begins just before dawn. That means just after the sun rises, the average zoo day begins. The sky will be slightly tinged with yellow when you are awakened by the bird song. Obviously, early in the morning, if you are living inside the zoo, you will have to get up by the bird song. You can hear a robin, a singing bird, singing. You can hear a robin singing. You hear the rich, fruity, slightly hoarse cries of the Taurakas. Taurakas is again a fruit-eating animal, African bird. And hoarse means you can go to the word nest to see the meaning. Hoarse means rough sounding. And Taurakas means a species of bird originally from Southern Africa. So you can get the meaning from here. So you can hear a robin singing early in the morning. You hear the rich, fruity, slightly hoarse cries of the Taurakas and a joyful blackbird. This Taurakas is a blackbird of a Southern African bird. At last, of his song dies, the white-headed thrush burst into an excited cry. Again, thrush is another kind of a bird. Looking out in the courtyard on the velvet green lawn, you can see an earnest group of peahens searching the dewy grass. Okay, grass full of dew, and these peahens, they used to search dew on this grass. A male peahen is dancing, his burnished tail raised like a fountain in the sunlight. Mark this one, you can get short answer from here. A male peahen is dancing, his burnished, that means polished tail raised like a fountain in the sunlight. In the sunlight, the tail is burnishing like a fountain. At 8 o'clock, the zoo staff arrives. So you can get a question like, what is the time, arrival time of the zoo staff? At 8 o'clock, the zoo staff arrives. You can hear them short greeting to each other. Sounds made, their buckets and brushes are heard. Obviously, they will, first of all, when they will enter the zoo, they will use buckets and brushes. That means to clean the zoo. You go out into the cool, fresh morning to see if all is right with the zoo. That means the author used to go out to see if everything is right inside the zoo. The monkey and other mammals live in a long, two-storied granite house. The monkeys and other mammals live here in this granite house. Here you find a lot of activity. The gorillas have been let out of their cages where the cages are clean. So when these cages are clean, the gorillas have been let out. They gallop about on the floor with the high spirit of children just out of school. As the children, they used to jump out of school when they get off. So that activity you can see here, the gorillas used to do. They try to wrench the electric heater from their sockets or break the fluorescent light. These are the activities they used to do. They try to wrench the electric heaters from their sockets or break the fluorescent light. Stephen, a name of a person, broom in hand, stand guards over the apes. Inside the gorilla's cage, Mike, again, name of a person, plump and ever, plump means students, you can say fat and stout body structure type of man, and ever smiling, is busy along with Jeremy. They sweep up the mess on the floor and scatter fresh white sawdust, that is powdery particles they used to scatter everywhere inside the zoo. Everything, they assure you, is all right before the coming of the visitors. All the animals excited and eager to start off a new day bustle about the cages. Item, the black syllables, ape. Item, the black syllables, ape. These apes are mostly found in Indonesian. These are Indonesian ape. Clings to wire bearing his teeth at you in greetings. That means this is the way Item, the black syllables, used to clings to the wire, bearing his teeth at you in greetings. Early in the morning, this is the way of greeting by this black syllables Item. Keep it till here. Next day, we'll continue from here. Now, take some question. Short this question. Obviously, you'll get answer from here. How is the turkey's cry? First write turkeys, then give apostrophe, then S. How is the turkeys cry? What do the peahen do? Question number 2. What do the peahen do in the early morning and where? Question number 3. Who live in the two-storied granite house? This is for your homework. Thank you.